downgrading to a Category 1 by Tuesday. Now, notice the cone of uncertainty, how wide that is. It covers the entire state of Florida, even our southern coastline as well here into Georgia. And that's because the models differ a little bit on where we'll go. So this is the European model, and you can follow along the storm as it begins to take more of a southerly track right on over toward Lauderdale, making landfall, even slowing it down a little bit, making landfall by Tuesday morning, early Tuesday morning. And then once we look at the American model, it follows the same path until it gets north of the Bahama Islands there and begins to move along the coastline a little bit further up to the north. So more of a northerly jog, making landfall closer to Jacksonville. With a scenario like this, it could mean more of that moisture spreading our way as we get into a Tuesday-Wednesday time frame, maybe even the remnants coming through our area with this particular model. So that's why we're watching this closely, because it could have some impacts on our weather as far as the remnants, that moisture. Of course, you see those little spin-up tornadoes with a scenario like that, so we'll watch it. That northerly, the southerly jog would be a more of a drier scenario for us. That northerly jog would be a wetter scenario. So our extended forecast really depends on what Dorian does. Right now, though, we do know the next couple of days will be dry and sunny for us. Temperatures will be close to 90 degrees over the next couple of days. You got 89 on Friday, Saturday looking at 88 for the high. We'll introduce a very slight risk for a shower on Sunday, 86. On Labor Day, a 30% chance for the rain at 87. And then from there, where do we go? We're going to keep a 30% chance for the rain in the forecast for now, both Tuesday and Wednesday, but Dorian will have a say-so in that in the coming days. And we'll keep you updated, of course, right here. And of course, download our 11 Live app to get the very latest as well.